All right, we've seen Tabatha Coffey with her very good work helping people and helping businesses change. But a new dynamic for the show for Bravo this time out, these are family businesses.
They are family businesses.
And so when we hear the phrase mom and pop,
yes,
that gives us all a warm feeling.
Yeah, of course.
Is that the best dynamic or not?
It's the backbone of American business, which is the amazing thing about it. I mean, all these small businesses and mom and pop stores are the backbone. The problem is when it's family, all the drama starts to come out and people don't resolve that. So that's what I go and do, try and resolve the business part as well as the personal.
And if you fix the personal, will that automatically fix the business or not necessarily?
It depends on the situation sometimes. I mean, it's this really bizarre thing with family. They know exactly how to push our buttons. They know exactly where to get us where it hurts. We do the same to them. And everyone reverts back to like seven-year-olds, you know, and that's the problem.
What kind of, we're gonna look at a clip in a second, what kind of businesses were you dealing with?
Oh, a very famous jewelry store, a couple of cafes, a children's clothing boutique on Melrose, which was amazing. That clip was a mother and daughter that started a conservative fashion wear based on their religion. So really diverse businesses, really diverse families. So a lot of blended families, really interesting stories. Some of them sad because a family member passed away really quickly and there wasn't a succession plan put in place of what was going to happen with everyone moving forward. But I really think something that we can all relate to, whether you have a business or not, because we all have a family, so we know what that feels like.
All right, here is a clip. Take a look. Watch this.
Would Anthony typically be here if I wasn't here?
No. He would be at home.
Okay.
In bed, probably on his phone.
Let me ask you this. How often
are you really in here?
Within this month, I've been coming in every 2 weeks, at least once a week.
Every two weeks is not once a week. Listen. How often do you come into the deli?
More than once a week.
Gone every 2 weeks, once a week, more than once a week. How often do you come in?
It depends on the month.
Oh, my God. You should be a f***ing politician because you just can't nail anything down.
Oh my goodness.
And you have him up against the wall.
So I'm going to make all these suppositions.
He can't get away.
He has money, so he's not starving.
He's not hungry.
And he's not hungry, so he just kind of comes in when he feels like it.
You know what the really interesting thing is? His mom is really struggling. You know, she went through a really painful divorce, really unexpected, was landed with this business that she really wasn't in total control of and all of a sudden was put in control of, trying to take care of her whole family, has him in college, so he needs to be helping out and manning up. And he wants to take over the business. He just wants to do it when he wants to, which was the problem.
Right.
Is there a common thing that you noticed all of them are doing wrong, all of the businesses that are struggling and failing?
A lot of people, because it's family, the trust level is always there, but no one's implementing a good structure of this is what each one of us are going to take care of and play into our strengths.
And this is what is expected
and
of
what
each
we
person.
Do. Right. So no one's holding anyone accountable and it becomes a free-for-all and it's anarchy.
Every great cable show has a pun for a title. Relative Success with Tabatha airs Wednesday night on Bravo. It's a requirement. It must be. Nice to see you this morning.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, Tabatha.
Thanks.